You've probably seen dry ice before, but did you know you can make it? In this project, you'll learn how to make some portable and on-demand dry ice using a pillowcase and a fire extinguisher. For this project, I picked up this CO2 fire extinguisher from a local fire equipment servicing company. It's a 15-pound extinguisher they had sitting in storage, and they said I could have it for free. It even came fully charged with 15 pounds of food-grade CO2. Now, these are special extinguishers, typically found in restaurant kitchens, mechanical rooms, or rooms with sensitive equipment like computers. You can know they're charged with carbon dioxide by stickers like these, or by holes punched in the servicing label. They also tend to have an extremely large discharge horn and no pressure gauges. The operation is pretty simple. Just remove the locking pin from the handle and squeeze down when ready. The tank is full of liquid CO2, but it comes shooting out as a gas and little chunks of dry ice snow. All the residue quickly evaporates, leaving everything as clean as when you started. It just makes it a little harder to breathe. Okay, now here's the trick to making dry ice. Take a cloth bag like a pillowcase and wrap it over the end of the discharge horn, pulling up all the loose material, then go ahead and give it a blast. The vapor is really cold, and it gets trapped at the bottom of the sack. There will also be some dry ice sticking to the discharge horn, so wipe that off as you're pulling it out. Alright, let's see what we got. Now, it's probably a good idea to be wearing insulated gloves when handling dry ice, because it's minus 78 degrees Celsius. It is extremely cold, but I found if I move it around quickly enough, it doesn't sit in one place long enough to give me a frostbite. Digging down to the bottom of the sack, you'll find larger clumps that look something like a dry ice snowball. Now, these are sublimating directly from a solid to a gas, so to preserve them a little longer, I'm going to transfer them into a little bowl like this one. This should make them a bit more convenient to work with, as well as keep the overall temperature low enough to slow down the reaction. Alright, the bowl is full, and there's our batch of dry ice, ready for experiments. Using something like the bottom of a glass or a jar, we can compact the snow to make it as dense as possible. Then gently set a lid over top. If you put the lid on too tight, the pressure of the gas will build and blow it off. Let's try the classic experiment of placing a few chunks in a container and adding some water. This is how we get the flowing fog you'd see in something like a Halloween witch's brew. This can also be poured out for a cascading waterfall effect. And look, there's no mess to clean up. If we add some dry ice to a container of warm water and screw on a lid with a small vent hole in it, we get a little CO2 geyser rocketing out of the top. Shaking it will speed up the reaction and increase it to a pressure that could possibly be used to drive a small motor. Well, now you know how to make dry ice whenever you need it, as long as you've got access to a CO2 fire extinguisher. Now, making fog is great, but there are crazier things that you can do with dry ice that you'll find in another project, like making a poor man's version of liquid nitrogen that's cold enough to flash freeze an orange. You'll also see how dry ice is used in making a tasty batch of carbonated ice cream. Well, that's it for now. If you like this project, perhaps you'll like some of my others. Check them out at thekingofrandom.com.